风望云作为题目，大家一起来勉励。
This morning, the topic I'd like to share is to watch the winds and to look at the clouds.
以前住在加州的时候，很喜欢开这个加州的一号公路因为那条公路在海边。
When I was living in California, I enjoyed driving down the PCH.
有时候会开到一个 scenic view 你下来可以吹吹海风看看天上的云。
There's many scenic views along the Pacific Coast Highway, and I could observe the winds and look at the clouds.
这个在疫情被关的当中呢，有时候这样看风望云也成为是一种奢望。
And so during the time of this pandemic, we long for days like that.
那今天早上想用这个题目，我们来谈，其实我们看风望云可以看到神的恩惠。
And so this morning, I'd like to share that just by observing the wind and regarding the clouds, we can see the grace of God.
我们看风望云可以看到现今的时候。
We can see what is happening in the present.
我们看风望云我们看到风云变色，我们不要也要记得那个控制风云后面的神。
And when we see the clouds changing colors, let us also remember the creator or the controller of the clouds and wind.
用这样的三点从圣经来彼此分享。
And so we'll use these three points as our mutual encouragement this morning.
我们看列王记上的十八章四十二节到四十五节。
Let's turn to First Kings.
列王记上十八章四十二节到四十五节。
First Kings 18 verses 42 to 45.
十八章四十二节到四十五节。
First Kings 18 verse 42 to 45.
这个记载以利亚祷告，那叫仆人去海边观看。
Here he records Elijah praying and asking his servant to go to the sea to look.
四十二节对仆人说：“你上去向海观看。”仆人就上去观看，说没什么。他说：“再去观看如此七次，十次。”第七次，仆人说：“我看见一片小鱼。”一片小云从海上来，不过人手那么大。以利亚说：“你上去告诉亚哈，当套车下去，免得被雨阻挡。”第四十五节。
45.
瞬时间，天阴风云黑暗，降下大雨。请读四十四节。
44.Then it came to pass the seventh time that he said, There is a cloud as small as a man's hand rising out of the sea. So he said, Go up, say to Ahab, prepare your chariot and go down before the rain stops you.
当时三年半没有下雨。
At the time, it was a 3.5 years of drought.
甚至人都要吃孩子。
And many people did not have much to eat.
后来以利亚祷告求雨。
And then Elijah prayed for rain.
叫仆人到海里那边去看一看。
And he instructed his servant to go to the sea to take a look.
我们看向从山看海你发觉到真的突然之间你心会打开。
And if you gaze towards the sea from the mountains, you truly feel that you become a little bit more open-minded.
从山看海，有时候你也会体会到海风的吹拂。
And looking at the sea from the mountains, you can also feel the breeze.
那仆人看到一小片云从海里升上来。
And the servant saw a small cloud forming.
以利亚就知道神开始工作了。
And Elijah knew that God was working.
瞬时风云黑暗就降下大雨。
And then the sky became black with clouds and wind, and there was heavy rain.
所以在看海的时候呢他们看到神恩惠的降临。
So when they looked toward the sea, they also saw the grace of God coming upon them.
那其实我们常常说神的话写在圣经当中，也写在大自然里面。
We often say that God's word is written in the scripture as well as in nature.
当我们看风看海，当我们接触大自然，我们有时候会看到一份神奇妙的创造。
When we look at the clouds and the wind and experience the nature, we will also feel God's great creation.
我们看诗篇十九篇一到四节。
Let's turn to Psalm 19, verse 1 to 4.
诗篇十九篇一到四节。
Psalm 19, verse 1 to 4.
诸天述说神的荣耀，穹苍传扬他的手段。从这日到那日发出言语，从这夜到那夜 传出知识，无言无语，也无声音可听。到这里就好，请读一到三节。
Verse 1, the heavens declare the glory of God, and the firmament shows his handiwork. Day unto day utters speech, and night unto night reveals knowledge. There is no speech nor language where their voice is not heard.
这边提到诸天啊，在讲神的荣耀。
Here it talks about the heavens declaring the glory of God.
穹窗啊，在传扬神的手段。
And the firmament shows his handiwork.
他们日夜都在传扬，虽然你听不到他的声音。
And day unto day utter speech, night unto night reveals knowledge.
我们英文说这个叫 sound of silence, 是一种没有声音的声音。
And in English, we call this the sound of silence.
但是你仔细的去观看神所造的，你就看到神奇妙的作为。
But if you carefully observe what God has created, you can see all his wondrous works.
所以圣经讲，自从天地以来，神的永能跟神性呢，是明明可以知道的。
And so in the heavens and the earth, we can see God's divine nature working.
虽然你看不到神，但是借着他所造之物就可以晓得神。
Even though we cannot see God, we can experience him through his creation.
我们刚刚说在疫情当中呢，很多人被关在家里很郁闷。
During the pandemic, many people were isolated in their homes.
最近有一个弟兄啊，决定跟他的小孩到大岛去看风望云。
And recently, there was a family who decided to take his children with him to the Big Island, to gaze upon the wind and the clouds.
这个弟兄就觉得，在疫情当中，孩子住那么远，可以团聚，可以一起看大自然，看神的创造，真的是非常幸福的一件事情。
This brother felt that during this pandemic, he was able to reunite with his family and take this trip. It was a very precious moment.
那大岛有一个活动，就是看那个 manta ray 那个到8尺到12尺的，好像海中蝴蝶的一种鱼啊，他们在海里追逐游戏像空中的蝴蝶一样。
And on the Big Island of Hawaii, there is something where they go out to watch the large manta rays that are 8 to 12 feet in length.
那你去看那个火山国家公园，火山正在爆发当中。
And then also going to observe the volcanoes in the Volcanoes National Park.
你在晚上啊，就好像看到它在放烟火，不定时的就喷出熔浆来。
And when you observe that active volcano at night, it looks like fireworks.
那你在高山上看到那个星云啊，看到原来天上的星星可以这么亮。
And on the mountaintops, you gaze upon the stars and see how bright they are.
那这个时候你会想到大卫所做的诗歌这样讲。
And it's at this time that you can reflect upon this song.
当我们看到你手指头所造的月亮星星，我们就想人算什么，你竟顾念他。
And that he has created the stars and the moon in the sky. And what is man that you are mindful of him?
所以弟兄姐妹，我们不要让我们的小朋友常常滑手机。
And so as parents, let us not let our kids use their cell phones too much.
我们要常常带我们的朋友去看风，去望云。
But bring them to observe the winds and to regard the clouds.
那你带他们出去的时候呢，你真的可以体会到一种亲情的。在大自然当中呢，亲情的一种天伦之乐。
Because we take them out together to enjoy nature, you can feel that bond.
当那位弟兄跟小朋友在一起的时候
，that bond and joy. And so when that brother brought his children out,
就想到拿俄米啊，借着路德得到一个孙啊。
He thought about Naomi having a grandchild through Ruth.
人家跟他说原来天上的神是应当称颂的。
And the woman told her that the God of heaven is to be praised.
因为今日神没有撇下你使你没无至亲的亲属。
For today the Lord has not forsaken you without an offspring.
他说这个孩子要提起你的精神。
And this, they said that this child should restore the life.
有时候我们跟很久没有见面的孩子在一起，我们觉得精神特别愉快。
When we don't see our children for a long time and we get to reunite with them, we feel very happy.
真的可以提起我们的精神。
And it also restores our life and our spirits.
所以看风望云我们看到神奇妙的作为。
So by observing the clouds, the wind, and regarding the clouds, we can see God's mighty works.
看风望云也让我们看清楚这个时候。
And watching the wind and looking at the clouds also allows us to be clear of what's going on.
我们看路加福音12章54节到56节。
Let's look at Luke 12, verses 54 to 56.
路加福音12章54节到56节。
Luke 12, 54 to 56.
耶稣这样讲,
And Jesus said this.
54节, 耶稣又对众人说, 你们看见西边取了云彩, 就说要下一阵雨, 果然就有了。 起了南风就说将要燥热也就有了假冒为善的人啊你们知道分辨天地的气色怎能不分辨不知道分辨这时候呢啊请读
54 Then he also said to the multitudes, whenever you see a cloud rising out of the west, immediately you say a shower is coming, and so it is. And when you see the south wind blow, you say there will be hot weather, and there is. Hypocrites, you can discern the face of the sky and of the earth, and how is it you do not discern this time?
耶稣谈到，当我们看风望云呐，我们就可以预测到明天是好天气还是坏天气。
And Jesus says that we're looking at the clouds and the wind, we can gauge whether or not the next day will be good weather.
耶稣就说呢，当我们看风望云可以预测知道时候，那我们也当知道现今的时候。
And so we can interpret the appearance of the earth and sky. Why? How do we not know to interpret the present time?
弟兄姐妹，我们一定听讲台说过，现今的时候就是主耶稣要再来很近的时候。
And we often hear that the present time is a time when Jesus is going to come.
所以我们在疫情来啊，这个时候呢，更要预备我们自己等候主耶稣再来。
And so especially during the time of the pandemic, we have to even more prepare ourselves for the Lord's coming.
那我们常谈到这个时候啊，我们会经历到这个四个古典的灾害。
We mentioned that we will encounter these great woes.
就是瘟疫、地震、饥荒、战争。
Which is a pestilence, famine, pandemic and the wars.
那可是我们常常忽略到呢，圣经上讲到这个来之前呢，啊，先有这个迷惑的人的出现。
And earthquakes. But before that, there will be people that come to deceive us.
我们来看马太福音24章。
Let's turn to Matthew 24.
我们要去理解，在我们这个世代啊，许多迷惑我们的会出现。
We have to understand that in our world, there will be many that come forward to try to deceive us.
我们来看24章的3节4节。
Let us look at 24 verses 3 and
4. 24章3节4节。
Matthew 24 verses 3 and 4.
耶稣在橄榄山上坐着，门徒暗暗的来说。 请告诉我们什么时候有这些事，你降临和世界的末了有什么异兆呢？第四节，耶稣回答说：“你们要谨慎，免得有人迷惑你们。”第五节，因为将来有好些人冒我的名来说我是基督，并且迷惑许多人。请读第五节。
And now, as he sat on the Mount of Olives, his disciples came to him privately, saying, "Tell us, when will these things be, and what will the sign of your coming and of the end of the age?" And Jesus answered and said to them, "Take heed that no one deceives you, for many will come in my name, saying, 'I am the Christ,' and will deceive many."
那下面才讲说会打仗呢，啊，会有地震呢，啊，所以在打仗、地震来之前，耶稣先提到什么？
And following that, it will talk about wars and earthquakes. But before that, what did Jesus say?
提到很多人呢，啊，会来迷惑我们。
He says that many will come to this, try and deceive us.
在传道者，在长子进修会的时候呢。 我们在谈到年轻人问的一个问题。
During the minister's workshop, we discussed questions that the youth had asked.
年轻人问说呢，在四世纪里面，怎么会有那种神职人员祭司啊，对他的妾这么无情啊？
They mentioned that in the book of Judges, why were some of the judges so heartless?
好像他的妾到外边去，这个自己把自己的妾推出去给坏人凌辱。 然后妾死掉了，又把妾的尸身切成12块。
And that they took their loved one out to others to be abused, and then they even cut up their body out their corpse afterwards.
就在问为什么神职人员这么没有情分呢？
And they ask, why is the man of the man of God or the minister of God so heartless?
我们都知道，世世时代是一个非常混乱的时代，因为。 国中无王，好像没有神一样哦，个人都任意而行啊。
We know that during the time of the judges, there was a time of chaos with no king, and so everyone did as they wished.
那我们仔细看四世纪的一种这种进程啊，就是他的演进呢， 他的败坏事实上是从宗教败坏开始的。
But we see that during that time, the degradation started from the religion.
是他们开始拜偶像，是他们开始自己施设祭司，施设节期。
They began to worship idols and set up their own festivals and their own priests.
到最后呢，因为宗教腐败了，结果呢，社会道德就乱了。
Because of this corruption in the religion, the moral values also had declined.
再来就带来战争，带来很多这个混乱的社会。
And that brought forth many wars as well as a very unstable society.
那今天的时代也是一样啊。
Today is the same way.
当我们在经历疫情的时候。
During the pandemic.
其实有一个弟兄这样讲，我们不只是有外在的瘟疫，我们也有内在的瘟疫。
Brother shared that we not only have external pestilence, but also internal ones.
那他是在讲什么呢？
What is he talking about?
这在我们联总开会的时候，这位弟兄这样讲，是在指着最近上海有一群人跑到非洲去那在混乱我们的教会，影响到许多人。
And he was talking about a certain group of former members that went to Africa to deceive our members.
我们在做开会的同龄呢，我们都是教会在帮忙圣工的人。
And all of us at the meeting are all workers in the church.
有时候弟兄姐妹拿一个网络的信息，你看，哎，这里讲说他们是真耶稣教会，他们也有我们的鸽子啊 ，logo 都一样啊，他们有很多的神迹奇事。
And then they share the art on the web, but they found that they claim to be True Jesus Church. They share the same logo as well as they perform miracles and wonders.
他们到非洲受洗的很多人，很多人经历了很多神的恩典。
And they go to Africa, they baptize many, then many experience the grace of God.
最后他会请你这个奉献到某某人的账号或是这个账号去。
In the end, they will ask them to make offerings to a certain person's account.
那我们这些帮助圣工的弟兄姐妹，我们要怎么样来回答这些问题呢？
So as workers of the Lord, how should we respond to these kinds of questions?
你知道，因为他们在疫情这群人上海这群杰出分子在疫情当中呢，他们一直待在非洲啊。
And so this group that came from Shanghai into Africa, they stayed there during the pandemic.
所以导致我们这个 AMC 我们非洲工作小组也要派工人也要进去来厘清，其实他们现在不属我们了。
And even the African ministry, AMC, they try to send workers there, but the other other party would not allow us.
有弟兄姐妹讲说，哎呀，他们也传耶稣啊，那耶稣不是说呢，不是抵挡我们的，就是帮助我们的吗
？And some claim that they also preach Jesus, and those who are not against us are for us.
就 leave them alone, 就让他们做他们想做的吧。
So just leave them alone, let them do what they need to do.
其实真的不一样哈，我们看。
But indeed, it is different. Let's refer to the scripture.
我们看约翰一书二章十八节到十九节。
Let's turn to 1 John 2, verses 18 and 19.
约翰一书二章十八节到十九节。
1 John 2, verses 18 and 19.
一书二章十八节到十九节。
1 John 2, verses 18 and 19.
小子们呐，如今是末时了，你们曾听见说。那敌基督的要来，现在已经有好些敌基督的出来了。从此我们就知道，如今是末时了。十九节，他们从我们中间出去，却不是属我们的。若是属我们的，就必能与我们同在。他们出去，显然都不是属我们的。请读。
Little children, it is the last hour, and as you have heard that the Antichrist is coming, even now that many Antichrists have come by which we know that it is the last hour. They went out from us, but they were not of us. For if they had been of us, they would have continued with us. But they went out that they might be made manifest that none of them were of us.
教会就是基督的身体。
We know that the church is the body of Christ.
如果你这样念你把基督换成真教会
And if we see Lord Jesus as the true church,
他说：“你们曾听见那敌真教会的要来，现在有好些敌真教会的出来了。”十八节，我现在在念圣经，把基督变成真教会
Okay, so we replace the Christ with the true church.
你跟着我，你跟着我翻哦。你们曾听见说那敌。真耶稣教会的要出来。
And as you have heard that the anti-true Jesus church is coming.
现在已经有好些敌真耶稣教会的出来了。
And there are many that are anti-True Jesus Church that have come.
从此我们就知道如今是末时了。
And by which we know that it is the last hour.
那这群人本来是属于我们的。
And these people were of us.
我回台湾，小弟回台湾的时候。
And when I went to Taiwan,
我遇到一位我一起长大的弟兄，他跟我讲，他在上海做生意的时候，还跑过去跟他们一起团契。甚至也在经济上帮助过他们。
And I encountered a member who shared with me that when he was in Shanghai, he also worshipped with them and even provided them support financially.
也劝过他们不要走自己的路。
And he also encouraged them not to go on their own ways.
但是他们却不听啊。
But yet they did not listen.
我们这个连总总负责前一任的也跟小弟说过，他也曾经去劝过这一群人。
And the former chairperson, the last chairperson of the IA also shared with me that he also.
所以他们曾经是属于我们的。
To encourage them, but and they were.
但是如今从我们当中出去了。
But now they have left from us.
就显明他们不属于我们了。
So it is clear that they are not from us.
那如果弟兄姐妹问我们这些工人说，他们到底错误在哪里呢？
And so if a brethren ask us.What mistakes are they making?
首先呢，他们主张呢，这个组织是属凯撒的。
Well, the first is that they believe that organizations are of Caesar.
他们是属圣灵的。
And they are of the Holy Spirit.
所以不用接受组织的差派。
So they do not need to be sent out by an organization.
他们认为耶稣不谈组织，保罗不谈组织，彼得也不谈组织。
They feel that Paul, Peter, and Jesus do not talk about organizations.
当他们没有离开组织的时候，从来不谈组织是属事的。
Before they had left the organization, they never talked about how bad organizations were.
但是他们离开组织之后，他们就谈组织是属凯撒的。
But after they have departed from the organization, then they start talking about associating it with
Caesar. 主耶稣真的不谈组织吗？
Did Lord Jesus never speak of organizations?
如果主耶稣不谈组织，为什么要组织十二个使徒呢？
If he did not, then why did he organize the 12 disciples?
如果主耶稣不谈组织，为什么他说外邦人有君王为主治理他们？那掌权的称他们为恩主。
And if Lord Jesus did not believe in organizations, why would he say that the kings of the Gentiles lorded over them?
但你们不可以这样。
But you cannot be, we cannot be like this.
你们为首的要像服侍人的。
But those who are in power must also serve.
我将我的国赐给你们，正如我父赐给你们一样。
And so I give my kingdom to you, just as my father has.
所以耶稣不是讲没有组织啊。
So Lord Jesus is not talking about not having organization.
他说他有国的国，怎么不是一个组织呢？
But he has a kingdom, and the kingdom not organized.
可是这个属神的组织呢，跟属世上的组织不一样。他们是以人为王，我们是任何要做带领的，都要成为服侍的人。
But the spiritual organization is different than the physical one. The physical organizations, they have man as their leader, while spiritual ones, the leaders are servants.
保罗不谈组织吗？
Did Paul not speak of organizations?
如果保罗不谈组织，为什么叫提多到处去按长老跟执事呢？
If he did not, why did he send Titus out to appoint elders and deacons?
为什么他会说一个身体，一个有许多的肢体，基督也是这样？
Why did he speak of the body with many different parts?
所以基督好像是一个身体。
So Jesus, Lord Christ, is like the body.
我们弟兄姐妹好像是肢体。
And we are the members of the body.
我们这个身体不是最好的组织吗？
Isn't this body the best organization?
所以他们第一个反对组织。
So first, they oppose organizations.
第二个，他们到肯亚去的时候呢，就把我们曾经除名过的三个主要工人通通召集起来。
And secondly, when they went to Kenya, they also gathered together three of the excommunicated members.
用他们呢来找到他们要传福音的对象。
And using them to find the people who they should preach to.
甚至想要交付他们工作。
And even entrust them with the holy work.
为什么他们这样做？
Why did they do this?
因为他们不相信除名。
They do not believe in excommunication.
他们认为耶稣没有除过名。
They believe that Jesus never excommunicated.
他们认为保罗没有除过名。
They believe that Paul never excommunicated.
他们认为彼得没有除过名。
And Peter never excommunicated.
所以除名是不合乎圣经的。
And so excommunication is against the Bible.
其实这个道理听起来很高兴的，没有除名多好。
And this seems very good. How good is it to not have excommunication?
真的耶稣不主张除名吗？
But did Jesus never speak of excommunication?
犹大真的没有被除名过吗？
Was Judas not excommunicated?
当然耶稣来到人间没有除过这
And it's true that Lord Jesus did not excommunicate anyone while he was on the earth. He said he did not come to earth to judge, but his words will judge in the future. Let's turn to Acts chapter 1, verses 18 to 20. Acts 18, 1.
18节, 这人, 这是在谈到犹大, 哦, 用他作恶的工价, 买了一块田, 以后身子扑倒, 肚腹崩裂, 肠子都流出来, 19节,
耶,
住在耶路撒冷的众人都知道这事, 所以按着他们那里的话, 给那块田地起名叫雅各大马, 就是雪田的意思, 20节, 因为诗篇上写着说, 愿他的住处, 变为方场, 无人在内居住, 又说, 愿别人得他的职分, 请读 20节。
For it is written in the book of Psalms, let his dwelling place be desolate, and let no one live in it, and let another take his office.
我们说, 犹大没有被除名吗?
So was Judas not excommunicated?
至少你这里看到他使徒的职分被除掉了。
At least from here we see that his office or his role was taken away.
至少在这里你看到他是不得救的一个人呢。
We can see here that he was not saved.
所以你说他没有除名，明明他的名字被使徒。
So was he not excommunicated? We can see here that his name was blotted away.
那到底耶稣同不同意除名呢?
So did Jesus agree with excommunication?
我们看马太福音18章,
Let's read Matthew 18.
18章的15节到17节,
Matthew 18:15-17.
他若不听你，你就另外带一两个同去，要凭两三个人的口作见证，句句都可定准。十七节，若不听他们，就告诉教会；若是不听教会，就看他像外邦人和税吏一样。十七节，请读。17
And if he refuses to hear them, tell it to the church. But if he refuses even to hear the church, let him be to you as like a heathen and a tax collector.
这里提到说，如果有弟兄得罪你呢，你要指出他的错误来。
Here it says that if a brother sins against you, you need to point out his fault.
他若听你，你就得到这位弟兄啊。
If he listens to you, then he have gained this brother.
另外一个抄本说，你弟兄若犯罪，没有说得罪你呢，哈。
And another versions it says that if a brother sins, not necessarily against you.
其实如果有弟兄得罪你，很简单，原谅他就好了啦。And
if a brother sins against you, it's easy, just forgive him.
但是如果弟兄得罪神又得罪你哦，那就不一样了。But
it's different if the brother sins against God and you.
我跟会做的同龄这样分享啊。I
shared this with our African brothers.
God forbid, 比如说有一个弟兄呢，啊 text 你的太太说，我们出去喝咖啡。
For instance, if a brother texted your wife and said, let's go out for coffee.
我们出去看场电影,
or let's go watch a movie.
那你刚好这个 text 被你看到了,
and if you saw this text,
啊, 你很生气啊,
you'd be furious.
弟兄啊, 你怎么可以得罪我? 你怎么可以得罪神?
Brother, how can you sin against me? How can you sin against God?
你不可以再这样做了,
you can no longer do this.
啊, 如果我们的弟兄悔改, 你得到这位弟兄,
and if our brother repents, then you have gained this brother.
啊, 如果他不听你,
but what if he doesn't listen?
啊, 你就把这个 text 给弟兄姐妹看,
what do? You show this text to other brothers and sisters.
凭两三人见证, 句句都要定准。
And if the two or three of them go to him,
后来他又带你的太太去犯罪,
and show him, reveal him his sins.
因为他们这个定准了, 又告诉教会了, 教会怎么办呢?
And if they already told the church, and what did the church do?
啊, 教会劝他们不可以再这样了,
and the church exhorts them not to continue doing this.
啊, 那么如果不听教会呢?
And what if he does not listen to the church?
这个已经是犯了很严重的罪了。
Then he has already committed a sin.
啊, 到最后又犯奸淫了,
and then later on, they may have committed adultery.
啊, 又不听劝, 啊, 最后就看他像外邦人跟税吏一样,
if they continue not to listen, then you treat them like a heathen and a tax collector.
啊, 这是主耶稣的话,
these are the words of the Lord
Jesus. 耶稣在世上不审判人,
when Jesus was on the earth, he did not judge others.
啊, 但是他的话要审判人,
but his words will continue to judge.
所以怎么可能耶稣不主张除名呢?
So how did Jesus not agree to excommunication?
保罗真的没有除过名吗?
Did Paul really not excommunicate?
我们看提摩太前书的一章十九节。
Let's turn to 1 Timothy 1 verse 19.
提摩太前书一章十九节。
1 Timothy 1 verse 19.
提摩太前书一章十九节。
1 Timothy 1 verse 19.
长存信心和无愧的良心，有人丢去良心，就在真道上如同破 船破了一样。其中有西米乃和亚历山大，我已经把他们交给撒旦，使他们受责罚，就不再毁谤了。请读。
Having faith in a good conscience, which having some having rejected concerning the faith, have suffered shipwreck, of whom are Hymenaeus and Alexander, whom I have delivered to Satan, in that they may not learn to blaspheme.
这里提到有人离弃了信心跟良心。
Here it talks that some have departed from the faith and good conscience.
保罗把他们交给撒旦。
And Paul have delivered them to Satan.
这不是除名吗？
Is this not referring to excommunication?
当然，今天我们教会不会随便除名。
Of course, the church does not excommunicate lightly.
弟兄姐妹，我们都知道，不是所有犯致死的罪都是除名的。
And not all mortal sins are should be excommunicated.
因为很多人想要很谦卑的回到教会里面来悔改，我们怎么会除他的名呢？
Because some people earnestly repent, how will we?
耶稣是罪人的朋友。
Jesus is a friend of sinners.
但是如果有人呢、啊，已经犯了严重的罪，回到教会又很高兴的，又继续已经犯了很不好的事情，又在教会啊，比如说犯了奸，又来教会追女朋友。
But if a person has already committed grave sins and still comes to church with no remorse and continues trying to sin,
他们就像我们身体上的一个癌细胞一样。
They are like a cancer cell in our body.
好像毒瘤一样。
They are like a tumor.
所以不是犯致死的罪就除名，而是犯致死的罪加上成为笑。
And so it is
影响到其他的人。
It's not mortal sins that we just excommunicate, but those who committed mortal sins and they continue to be like yeast infecting others.
您上次听到一般的信徒被除名是什么时候？
And when was the last time that you heard someone was excommunicated?
几乎没有，不是吗？
It's almost rare to none. Why?
因为他们没有成为笑。
Because they did not become like a yeast.
真的，所以不是没有这个制度。
So it is not that we don't have this order.
这是圣经上的话。
But because these are the words from the Bible.
最啊，我小弟觉得最离谱的啊，上海这一群人，他们主张是，只要任何人受过圣灵，即使他是慕道朋友，都可以出去为其他的人施洗。
I think the most extreme belief that they have is that anyone who has a Holy Spirit, whether or not they've been baptized or not, they can go out and baptize others.
我说哇，怎么有这样？这个本来是说我们本来就没有这样的道理啊，为什么出去之后发明这种新道理呢？
We've never had this kind of doctrine. Why did they invent this?
因为他们说彼得不是得到圣灵之后就帮人洗礼吗？
And they say, did Peter not baptize others when he received the Holy Spirit?
他说，请问彼得有受过洗吗？彼得没有受过洗啊。
But I asked, was Peter baptized?
啊，彼得没有受过洗，他得到圣灵可以帮人家洗礼，所以我们任何没有受过洗的人呢，只要受圣灵了，都可以帮别人来施洗。
And so they believe in the same way that without being baptized, as long as you have the Holy Spirit, you can also baptize others.
圣经真的这样说吗？
But the Bible really say this?
我们看约翰福音三章二十二节。
Let's turn to John chapter 3.
约翰福音三章二十二节。
John 3 verse 22.
三章二十二节。
John 3 verse 22。
这是以后耶稣和门徒到了犹大地，在那里居住施洗。请读。
22. After these things, Jesus and his disciples came into the land of Judea, and there he remained with them and baptized.
这里提到两组人，就是耶稣跟门徒。
Here it talks about two groups of people, Jesus and his disciples.
他们住在犹大地。
And they came into the land of Judea.
他们施洗。
And there they baptized.
那不可能门徒洗耶稣啊。
And the disciples would not baptize Jesus.
啊，所以只有可能耶稣洗门徒。
So it is most likely that Jesus baptized the disciples.
啊，所以门徒彼得真的没有被施过洗吗
？So was Peter disciple? Was he never baptized?
我们读四章的一节二节。
And let's turn to
约翰福音四章一节二节。
John 4 verses 1 and 2.
主知道法利赛人听见他收门徒施洗比约翰还多。第二节，其实不是耶稣亲自施洗，乃是他的门徒施洗。请读。
Therefore, when the Lord knew that the Pharisees had heard that Jesus made and baptized more disciples than John, although Jesus himself did not baptize, but his disciples.
啊，这边提到呢，有人听到耶稣收门徒比啊这个约翰还多啊啊，因为他收门徒，当时的收门徒就施洗来收门徒啊。
Here it says that they heard Jesus made and baptized more disciples than John.
那其实到后来才会知道，原来耶稣洗过门徒之后呢，是门徒去施洗，不是耶稣施洗。
And then we realize later that is the disciples who actually baptized after Jesus had baptized them.
所以弟兄姐妹，当我们的一般的弟兄姐妹呢，拿这个上海一群人所 所宣传的文宣来问我们的时候
，And so brothers and sisters use these articles from this group in Shanghai to ask us.
我们就知道原来那些迷惑的人已经出来了。
And then we will need to understand that the people who have come to deceive have already appeared.
我们要跟他们讲，他们到底什么地方离开了真道。
And we need to explain to them where they have deviated from the truth.
其实假先知不只在教会里面。
Actually, false prophets do not exist just in the church.
外面呢，我们也常常看到、听到一些 很奇奇怪怪的信息啊。
We have also heard many strange things on the outside.
现在很多人不想要打疫苗，有许多的原因呢。
There's many people that have their own reasons why they do not want to be vaccinated.
但是也有人因为听从一种说法，所以他们就拒绝打疫苗。
But there's also a group of people that heard certain kind of a theory that prevents them from wanting to be vaccinated.
他们说这个疫苗啊，其实就是兽的印记啊。根据启示录呢，这个兽啊会给人盖印啊。
And they believe that this vaccination is the mark of the beast, as referred to in Revelation.
我们在这个传道者长子灵修会的时候，我们谈到这个问题。
During the minister's workshop, we discussed this problem.
没有正式统计，但是没有人同意啊，这个疫苗就是假先知的。这个兽的印记了，没有人同意。
We didn't take account or anything, but there was a general agreement that vaccination is not a sign of a beast.
所以弟兄姐妹，我们看看风望云啊，我们就知道现在的时候。
So brothers and sisters, if we observe the winds and regard the clouds, we can see this current time.
我们不只是要注意外在的瘟疫。
And we need to also pay attention to the pestilence and the pandemic.
也要注意内在的瘟疫
，as well as the internal ones.
能够有一个防备
，and so to guard ourselves.
看风望云呢、我们有时候看到风云变色
，and when we observe the wind and regard the clouds, we see sometimes the clouds may change color.
但是呢，也不要忘了掌握风云的神呢。
But don't forget the master behind who controls.
我们看传道书十一章第四节
，that controls the clouds and the winds. Let's turn to Ecclesiastes chapter 4.
传道书十一章第四节。
Ecclesiastes 11, verse 4.
十一章第四节。
Ecclesiastes
11,
verse 4.
必不杀种，望云的必不收割。请读。
He who observes the wind will not sow, he who regards the clouds will not reap.
如果我们一直只注意风云的变化，我们有时候连最基本那个有时效性的工作，我们都会放弃，不想做。
If we focus too much on the changes from the wind and the cloud, we may forget even the most basic duties.
你看风啊，风这么大，今天撒种会撒这个撒不到田里啊，不撒了，不撒了。
If we observe that the wind is blowing hard, blowing very strong, you may say, well, it's going to blow away the seeds, so we're not going to sow today.
你本来要收割的哦，你看到哎呀，云来了，快要下雨了，没地方晒谷子啊，不收割了，不收割了。
And if today you were supposed to reap and you observe the clouds and you think it's going to rain, you may say, I don't.Don't need to reap today.
所以哦，你看风望云，有时候这个看啊，这个英文用 observe 哦，就是你的眼睛只有专注在这个危险的事情啊，在这个风云的变化。
And so if we observe too much and focus too much on these things, we only see the risk, the danger.
有时候神交代的，我们当尽的本分，我们呢会忘记掉。
And sometimes even the most basic duties that the Lord has entrusted us, we may neglect.
撒种就是传福音。
To sow is to preach the gospel.
保罗说：“我撒种，亚波罗浇灌。”
Paul says, "I planted and Apollos watered."
收割就是拯救灵魂。
And to reap is to save souls.
这是神托付给教会当做的事情。
This is what God has entrusted to the church.
那有时候我们因为疫情来了，教会被关闭了。有时候我们怕了，我们连最基本的，因为看风云的变化呢，连最基本的我们都忘了去做。
But at times, such as during the pandemic, the church has closed, and we have even forgotten to do our most basic duty to preach the gospel.
如果您读十一章的第一节
，If we look at chapter 11, verse 1,
传道书十一章第一节
，Ecclesiastes 11, verse 1,
当将你的粮食撒在水面。因为日久必能得着。
Cast your bread upon the waters, for you will find it after many days.
请读第六节。
And verse 6, in the morning,
早晨要撒你的种，晚上也不要歇你的手，因为你不知道哪一样发旺，或是早撒的，或是晚撒的，或是两样都好。
In the morning, sow your seed, and in the evening, do not withhold your hand, for you do not know which will prosper, either this or that, or whether both alike will be good.
很少人把种子撒在水面上。
Few people would sow on the water.
但是这里经文讲说呢，即使这是非常unusual, 非常不正常哦，但是你这样做呢，早晚也会得到收成啊。
But even though this is unusual, sooner or later you will reap harvest.
那早上要撒, 晚上要撒, 因为你不知道早, 早上撒的, 还是晚上撒的, 哪一个会成长, 或者是两样都会成长。
And you need to sow in the, both in the morning and in the evening because you don't know which one will prosper.
但是你看风这么大, 你就不想撒了?
But when you see the wind is blowing so strongly, you may say, I don't need to sow.
但是撒种又是神要让我们做的。
But sowing is something that God has told us. It's our basic duty.
务要传道, 无论得时, 不得时, 总要专心。
So Paul says that we need to preach in season and out of season.
这个疫情哦, 影响我们的判断太大。
This pandemic has impacted our decision making. Sometimes our minds are flooded with the news reports.
报纸上这样讲,
the newspaper says,
这个天天看疫区的死亡数字哦, 然后物资的缺乏哦, 就特别揪心了。
And that if we continue to look at the statistics of the pandemic and the number of deaths,
都叫你为老人咳嗽哦, 都很担心他到底是不是 COVID 了。
And it makes us very anxious and nervous that when even if someone coughs, we wonder if they have COVID.
又不敢带他去看医院啊。
And then we're afraid to bring them to the hospital.
真是急死了哦。
And people become extremely anxious.
报纸上又说, 因为常常在家里, 我们的意志都是比较消沉的。
The newspaper also says that because we're often at home, we become more pessimistic.
现在每个人啊, 在家里都抱一个手机啊。
And many people have cell phones.
有时候也不会觉得饿啊, 因为一天到晚在看手机啊。
And they may not feel that anything's different because they can just browse their
phones. 疫情当中最糟糕就是家里如果有一个性情比较暴躁的人啊。
But during the pandemic, the worst thing that can happen is there's somebody with a bad temper at home.
他说自从2019年来, 这个有大概有40亿人啊, 被关在疫情当中啊。
Ever since 2019, there are about 4 billion people that have been locked at home.
那他说如果家里有一个比较有暴力倾向的, 那个妇女跟孩子, 在这段时间又是特别的辛苦。
But the women and the children are extremely suffer more during this time if there's someone at home with them that has a very bad temper.
因为呢, 常常会接受家暴。
And they have a lot of domestic
violence. 所以当我们活在这个郁闷的时代啊, 心情很不好的时代啊。
And so we're living in this time where people are pessimistic and angry.
我们要决定传福音, 我们要决定什么时候教会开门, 有时候呢, 我们真的只望风看云啊, 有时候我们忘了最基本的神要我们做的是什么。
And we have to decide when we need to preach the gospel, when we need to open the church again. Sometimes we forget these very fundamental, these basic things that the Lord has entrusted to us.
圣经上说呢, 六日要工作。
The Bible says that we need to work for 6 days.
第七日要向神守安息。
And on the seventh day, we need to observe the Sabbath.
又说当有盛会。
And we need to have a feast.
盛会啊, Holy Assembly.
Or Holy Assembly.
所以, 路加福音第四章, 耶稣按照素常的规矩做什么呢? 安息日, 守安息什么呢? 进入会堂。
And in Luke chapter 4, Jesus did as his custom was, which was he entered into the temple on the Sabbath day.
使徒行传17章, 保罗按照素常的规矩去哪里呢? 啊, 进入会堂。
In Acts, Paul also did according to his custom to enter into the temple.
耶稣被逼迫, 他安息日就不进入会堂了吗?
And did during under persecution, did Jesus not observe the Sabbath?
保罗生命危险, 安息日, 他就不进入会堂了吗?
When Paul's life was in danger, did he not observe the Sabbath?
啊, 所以当我们在做判断的时候,
so when we're making these decisions,
啊, 我们真的有时候要想到神要我们做什么?
We need to consider what the Lord wants us to do.
我不是说我们要违反政府的法律,
I'm not saying that we rebel against the government.
我不是说我们不要关心弟兄姐妹的身体健康,
or that we do not care about our brothers and sisters' health.
但是我们到底只关心身体的健康, 还是灵性的健康呢?
But are we only focused on our physical health and not our spiritual one?
啊, 我们到底是关心, 啊, 这个只有法令呢, 还是神的规条呢?
Do we only care about the laws of the land or God's commandments?
啊, 当然, 我们每个教会整个职会都在做决定。
And of course, all the church councils around the country, they have to make their decisions.
啊, 感谢主, 现在美国所有的教会都打开了。
And thank God, all the churches in the U.S. have opened up.
啊, 但是我们要知道, 这种艰难的时刻呢, 还会再遇到。
But we must understand that these trying times will happen again.
啊, 这样的决定啊, 有时候常常会又回到我们的面前来。
These decisions that we have to make will resurface in the future.
我们有时候谈到信仰的可贵在哪里呢? 信仰的可贵在哪里?
Well, what's the preciousness of our faith?
就是很多人在面对风云变色的时候呢, 知道神是掌握风云的神啊。
Is that when people see that the clouds are changing colors, that they understand who controls the clouds.
我们对古圣徒很多人他们的决定我们非常的感动。
And we are moved by many of the decisions our ancestors, the saints of old, have made.
以斯帖要去见王,
when Esther was going to see the king,
她自己进食也找别人进食,
she fasted and found others to fast with her.
她说我要违例啊, 就是这个是没有这个例子了。 如果王不给我恩典,我就完蛋了,我要违例去见王, 那我若死就死吧。
And she says that she will go against the king, and if she dies, if she perishes, she perishes.
我们坐在这里就很感动。
And that is very moving.
到最后神也给他开了一条路。
And in the end, God opened up a way for her.
我们看到彼得一传福音,就被关到监牢里面去。
We see Peter, when he started evangelizing, he was put in prison.
严严警告他, 你不可以再奉拿撒勒人的名再传福音了。
It says that you can no longer preach in the name of Jesus of Nazareth.
被放出去,又开始传福音。
And when he was released, he resumed preaching.
那进来又被抓, 怎么办呢?
And then he was rearrested again.
他们说我们所看见,所听见的, 不能可以不说。
He said that we cannot withhold what we have seen and heard.
他们心里觉得喜乐, 因为觉得自己是配为这个名来受逼迫的。
Their hearts are feeling joyous because they are willing to be persecuted for,
我们读到早期的这个福音传到山, 台湾的山地。
In the early days, when the gospel was preached into Aboriginal areas in Taiwan,
当时的逼迫非常厉害,
the persecution was strong.
但是他们也不停止聚会,
but they did not cease to worship together.
他们有时候在山上的猪寮聚会,
sometimes they worship in different areas in the mountain.
有时候在水边的河坝当中聚会,
sometimes they worship right next to a creek.
有时候在比较远的坟墓旁边聚会,
and they even worship out in other remote areas.
就是不愿意停止聚会,
they refuse to cease worshiping.
所以弟兄姐妹, 我们听到这样的见证, 我们也很感动。
So when we hear these kind of testimonies, we are moved by it.
所以求主耶稣感动我们哦。
So may the Lord move us.
我们不只是看风云,
and compel us so that we are no longer, we don't just look.
看风的不撒种, 望云的不收割了。
And observe the clouds and observe the winds and not sow and regard the clouds and not reap.
我们也看掌握风云的神。
But we also need to look at the master, the one who controls the clouds and the wind.
今年夏天啊, 这个东部啊, 要举开这个 J2 SSC in person, 就是让高中生的学生啊, 住在教会。
This past summer in the East Coast, they were going to hold the J2 Student Spiritual Convocation for high school students.
真的有的家长非常的忧心啊, 怎么可以这样? 教会怎么可以这样?
There was a parent that was very worried and wondered why the church would do such a thing.
你这样不是给我们家长很大压力吗? 不是给我们孩子很大压力吗?
Don't you put a lot of pressure on us as parents as well as our children?
但是教会是想说呢, 暑假过后, 马上学生都要回学校了。
The church was thinking that after the summer, students will have to return back to school.
你看哦, NBA playoff, 那个 auditorium 挤满了人啊。
And you see the arenas for the NBA playoffs are filled with people.
你看现在餐馆打开, 餐馆也挤满了人啊。
And when the restaurants open, the restaurants are also filled with people.
啊,我们的孩子来住教会, 你真的担心?
And are you that worried about your children coming to stay at church?
担心就祷告了哦。 担心就祷告。
So if we're worried about it, let us pray.
那为什么教会要这样做呢?
And why does the church want to do this?
实在看到一年多来, 这个小朋友在家里面真的很可怜。
We have seen how the situation with the children, they have been locked at home for a year.
这个常常上网, 常常抱着手机。
They're often online, they're often on their phones.
跟亲子之间啊, 又常常冲突。
And there's often a friction between the parents and
啊,
the children.
又没有朋友。
And they don't have much friends.
啊, 觉得教会觉得他们要上大学了, 你不给他们朋友, 将来怎么办?
And the church feels that without friends and they're going to college, how are they going to continue on?
感谢主啊, 20多个住在教会啊。
And thank the Lord, there were 20-some that stayed at the church.
说实话, 小弟也蛮紧张的了哦。
And truthfully, I myself was nervous.
很多同工, 我们只能够交托神啊, 不能怎么办?
But all we could do was entrust it to God.
我们也是有惊无险的时刻啊。
It was also a very risky situation.
一个小朋友突然生病了。
Because if a
if a child got sick,
我们就决定, 如果有人得 COVID, 马上回家上课,
and we decided that if someone received COVID, then we would end the spiritual convocation.
啊,感谢主, 不是 COVID, 啊。
But one person did get sick, but thank the Lord, it was not COVID.
一个煮饭的妈妈, 突然之间呢, 低烧。
And so there was
煮饭的妈妈,
there was a mother who was cooking in the kitchen, and she had a low-grade fever.
啊,感谢主, 后来检查也是, 啊, 也不是 COVID.
And thank the Lord that she was tested later, and it was not COVID.
你知道,小弟在那边常常很羡慕小朋友的那种欢笑声啊。
I enjoy listening to the laughter of the children.
因为那两个辅导员刚好是将要订婚了哦。
And two of the counselors, they were getting engaged.
那个小朋友在这个 bedtime story 的时候呢, bedtime 的时间呢, 那个就寝的那个时间, 啊, 一直追着辅导员问啊, 你们是怎么认识的? 哎, 问到大家谈的笑哈哈这样子啊。
And so they were so innocent that during the bedtime sharing, they kept asking this engaged couple how they met each other.
所以你体会到他们，你听到他们的笑声，哈，啊，听到他们祷告的声音。
And they giggled and laughed. And when you listen to this laughter, when you listen to their prayers,
你觉得我们这样所做的都是可以感谢的。
We think that what we have done, we are very thankful for.
求主帮助我们,
and may the Lord help us.
不只是看风云,
to not just observe the winds,
也看风云后面的神,
and regard the winds, but the one who...
今天我们就用, 这样的, 看风, 望云, 这样彼此来全面。
But the one who controls the winds and the cloud.
我们可以看到神的恩典。
So that we can see the grace of the Lord.
我们也可以看到现在的, 这个假先知的活动,
and we can see the activities of the anti the false prophets.
我们也看到后面掌握风云的神,
and that we can see the God who controls the winds and the clouds.
我们也唱诗,
let us sing him.
440首,
let us rise and sing him 441.